Hi there once again and welcome back to my video. Today I came back to a place called Arlapsey. It's a cloudy day, might rain also. And I'll be taking some shots here and turning them into long exposure. And then I'll be heading back down to the studio and I'll be turning them into black and white. So stay with me throughout the video and I'll show you my editing process. I'll be heading this way. I was here a few weeks ago and I took some shots from down there. But today I'll be taking some shots somewhere about here. There's a dog down below barking. Lovely cloud coverage today, great for black and white. I'm gonna set up my tripod and camera and I'll catch you later. Well, we're back in the studio everyone and I've decided I won't be turning the image into black and white. I'll be doing a color edit today. I'm going to take a break from black and white, but don't worry, my next video after this will be in black and white editing. I'm going to show you how to edit dark and moody seascape images, and I think this image will turn out great in color. So let's head over to the computer and start the editing process. Make sure to hit the subscribe button and give me a like so you can watch my other videos on editing black and white photography images. Please leave any comments below and I'll be sure to answer every comment. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching and let's begin the editing. Well, here we are over at the computer and I'll be using Adobe Camera Raw to edit this image. The first thing I'm going to start off with is turning the profile to Adobe Landscape, where we get some more color in the image. Then I'm going to head over to the exposure panel on the right side and I'm going to start by decreasing the exposure by just a few stops. This was a long exposure shot of 2 minutes. And now I'm gonna decrease slightly the highlights, increase a bit of shadows, increase the whites so we don't have clipping on the top right histogram on the right side, and the same for the blacks on the left side of the histogram. When you see white, just go back down, dial it down a bit. I'm not going to touch the contrast. I'm going to increase the exposure just a bit. To around there, I'm going to adjust the clipping on the black. Now I'm going to head over to the effects panel. I'm going to give it just a touch of texture. And a touch of clarity to around there. Like I said, we'll be editing this image in color, not in black and white today, guys. I'll do the next video of editing an image, a seascape, in black and white, but today we're going to try the color. I'm going to give it just a bit of dehaze to around there. Gonna go back up to the exposure and increase the blacks to reduce again the clippings on the left side. I'm gonna head down to the calibration tab, increase the saturation blue primary, not too much, to around there. And next, I'm going to head over to the color grading, guys. I've never shown you this tool before. We're going to give some highlights, give some more color in the highlights. We're going to give it just a touch of warm color. And we're going to move this button circle on the outer side to where we see like a golden color. And we grab the inner circle and move it towards the outer circle. Hold your shift key, the arrow, so you get that straight line. And we're going to give just a touch of color in the highlights. Don't go too far, it gets weird. And I'm going to give a blue color in the shadows. Move the outer button, the circle. Hold the shift key so you get that straight line. If you don't hold the shift key, you're gonna move everything around. So by holding the shift key, you get a straight line. Not too much, just about there. And next I'm gonna go over to the color tab and I'm going to decrease the temperature just a bit. Not too much. Go back to where it was, to around there. I'm going to decrease a bit of tint and give it a touch of vibrance and a touch of saturation to around there. Next, I'm going to head over to the detail panel, sharpen it a bit, to around 40, I always reduce the radius and increase the detail. Hold down the masking slider and hold down the Alt key to sharpen just the white parts of the image. To around there. I think I'll increase the sharpening around 50. And now we're going to start with the masking. The first mask I'm going to use is the linear gradient. I'm going to place it over the top part of the sky at a slight angle. So we try to miss the hill, or, well, it's not a mountain, the cliffside on the left. And I'm going to decrease the exposure to about there. I'm going to use another linear gradient. I do this for my black and white images also, just to give that depth of field to the viewer. About there, I'm going to use the same linear gradient for the foreground. And just reduce the exposure around there. Next thing I'm going to do is use a radial gradient, and I'm going to put it where the sun has risen around here. I'm going to increase it a bit, and I'm going to give it some color. But before that, I'm going to subtract, use a brush, and remove it from the rock here, like that. And here I'm going to increase, where is it gone? Just increase the temperature a bit and give it that warmish glow. Don't go too much. I think there should be okay. And a bit of tint. I'm going to step out from the masking a bit. I'm going to check the before and after by pressing the P on the keyboard. And that's the before. And that's the after. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to use another brush. I mean another mask, and I'm going to use the brush, and I'm going to brush away on the rocks here. You don't have to be precise. And on this side also, reduce the size of the brush by turning the wheel on the mouse. Gonna reduce it even more. And here I'm gonna sharpen the image just a bit more. Around there. That should be okay, guys. I'm going to use another brush. You can press key on the keyboard if you want, instead of pressing the brush up here. I get another brush, and I'm going to just do a bit of dodge and burn around here. On the whiter parts of these rocks. Oh, it seems to have gone over here. No worries. I'm going to subtract it.
Sometimes it's good to make a mistake, because we always learn from our mistakes. I'm going to subtract here. And here I'm going to increase the exposure just a bit. To around there. Next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to use a radial gradient. And I'm going to give it a slight increase in exposure where the sun had risen, about here. And again, I'm going to use the subtract, the brush, and I'm going to remove the mask from these rocks. Because the sun won't be shining on these rocks. And now I'm going to increase the exposure. To around there. I'm going to use another radial. And I think we're ready with this image. And I'll be doing a vignette. Somewhere like here. Always place your vignette on the brightest part of the image where the sun had risen, or the direction of light. And I'm going to invert it, the mask, and reduce the exposure. I'm going to increase it just a bit more, and I think I'll reduce the exposure to around there. And that should be okay. Out of the masking, guys, and I'm going to show you the before and after once again. Pressing the P, that's the before. The amazing difference when using a RAW file and editing it with masking and adjustments of the sliders. Well, thank you guys for watching the video. Hit the subscribe button, a thumbs up, and as usual, leave any comments below and I'll make sure to answer them all. Thank you guys. And I'll see you in another video.